Thank you very much, Dr. Aung San Suu Kyi. First of all, it is a privilege to visit Madame Aung San Suu Kyi after having visited Mexico and the leaders of this country and having discussed many issues with them. We have now closed the loop, full circle. And I must say that ASEAN is very, very much encouraged by this new wave of reforms and openings. And I find the views in Mexico and the intention down here of Madame are somehow converging. And I think it's going to be a convergence that ASEAN will be supporting, that will help Myanmar develop and integrate with ASEAN more effectively, and through ASEAN serving as a bridge, as a gateway out to the global international community. I think this is a new era for Myanmar and for ASEAN, and certainly for the international community. In NEPITO, of course, we talk about the preparation for the year 2014 and the significance of that year. And all these developments are part of the preparation and a part of the consolidation of this particular member of ASEAN to be in the chair, to be effective, and to be contributing and to be supportive of the ASEAN integration, and certainly will be good for Myanmar, because it will be a year that Myanmar can showcase so many things, her achievements and her aspirations, her developments, her readiness to engage with ASEAN, to engage with the world. So that's the message, and I find tremendous inspiration from discussing with Madame Aung San Suu Kyi. She has shared with us many of her ideas, her concerns, and her views about this country and about the region. Thank you. Suu Kyi Chayun.
ASEAN claims that this reform in Burma is the result of their so-called constructive engagement.
I think that many people claim that they have helped Burma to come to this point. Not just ASEAN, but other countries as well. And I think, of course, the greater part of the credit must go to the people of Burma themselves.
With the superpowers from the West playing such a big role, at the same time, Asia is also growing. How do you balance interest from the West, China, and ASEAN, which is around the region, really leadership and you be able in Burma to keep a proper balance?
This is something that we have had to work at. It won't, of course, come easily, because we are between two of the largest and most powerful countries in the world. And of course, ASEAN is on one side of us, apart from the Western powers who are further away, but with whom we also expect to be very closely linked in friendship. I think it is not impossible for us to be friends with everybody, to maintain relationships based on friendship and understanding and mutual respect. We all have much to offer one another. Burma has experiences which other ASEAN countries have not had, and we can share our experiences with them, and they their experiences with us. In the same way, I think we have much to offer the West, even though we are, economically speaking, a poor, underdeveloped country. We still have much to offer the West in the way of our spiritual values and our cultural values. So I hope that it will be a sharing process. We will learn from the rest of the world, and we hope that the rest of the world will also find some things to learn from us.
Do you think this is the right time to be able for more progress in the UN? And this will be for the time for the minister is about to come to Burma. What are your feelings about the European Union and how many times the government can have this
solution? With regard to the European Union, I understand that the lifting of the sanctions will be related to how the by-elections go. So as I understand that, the decision will be made after the by-elections as to the way in which they will start to lift the sanctions. It will probably be calibrated, and I agree with that. I think this is the right way to go about it. With regard to the Italian Prime Minister, I probably will have to ask him about his national football team.
Struggle for democracy and ongoing now struggle with the Arab Spring or the Arab Revolution. How much similarity do you see and what do you see for the institution for also the Nobel Prize winner lady of Yemen, Mrs. Kalman?
I think what the Arab Spring taught us is that peoples everywhere are linked by a love of liberty and a love of fairness. Justice, liberty, fairness. These things I think are loved by peoples all over the world. And for many people in Burma who may have thought that they had very little to do with the Arab world, it was a revelation. And I think it was a good revelation that we all share the same basic values. Of course, how we go about achieving our goals will be different because that will depend on our circumstances and also on our cultural values. But I believe greatly in the brotherhood of man. I should say the sisterhood of man. It's very difficult to get the genders right these days.
Philippines, I'd just like to know your thoughts about our very own democracy icon, Bongbong Marcos. What example we are setting for the ASEAN, and what now is your own definition of a good democracy?
With regard to Mrs. Aquino, I have to say that I have always been very grateful to her for the way in which she has supported us throughout our very, very difficult years. So we do not just admire her, we have great affection for her. And we have transferred the respect and admiration to her son, who I hope will be following in her footsteps very closely. With regard to what we have to learn from one another, as I said earlier, the paths that we choose will be different. And it needs to be different because we are different countries. But still, we can always hold out a hand of friendship. And if one stumbles, the other should help the other along, should say, put out a friendly hand.
Thank you. Singapore being one of the developed countries in ASEAN, how do you foresee the Myanmar surpassing Singapore in 10 years? So, what role?
Well, why not? Why not? You need to be ambitious.
What
ASEAN certainly welcomes that simple ambition that, you know, in 10 years, Myanmar will surpass ASEAN. But in any case, Myanmar will have to work very, very closely with ASEAN to connect with the dynamism of ASEAN and to work with the synergy that ASEAN has with the world. We welcome that, and certainly we wish the competition will be very, very good.
Our relationship with Singapore has always been good, and Singapore has been particularly helpful along this period of transition and democratization. So I hope that we will be able to maintain closer relations. And I'm very, very happy to think that the countries of ASEAN are waiting to be surpassed by Myanmar.
What extent do you think the two countries can cooperate?
I think real cooperation needs equality. At the moment, economically speaking, there is no real equality between Burma and Thailand. We've got to admit that. The facts are facts. Once we get to a situation where our economies are more on an equal level, I think we can increase the areas of our cooperation, and exchanges between the two countries would progressively help boost us. Well, the ties between Indonesia and Burma are special in many ways. I think ever since the days of our struggles for independence, our respective struggles for independence, there have been close relations between Indonesia and Burma, and between the Indonesian leaders and the Burmese leaders. And we used to say that somehow we look more like the Indonesians than like the other peoples in ASEAN. Although I don't think that's true, because I don't think I can tell apart Cambodians, Laos, and Thais from Burmese. We used to say that they can. I just think, well, I don't know whether they really can, but I can't. But we do feel a very special warmth with regard to Indonesia because of the ties that go back our respective struggles for independence, and also, of course, Indonesia lived for many years under a military regime, and so did Burma. So that also brings closer together.
So I'd just like to know what was discussed and what these neighboring countries such as Malaysia could help in development of Burma.
Well, it was a very invigorating meeting that we discussed many, many issues. Of course, a lot of it centered on how we would like to see Burma developing and how ASEAN can be involved, the same kind of questions that we're discussing now. It was a very good meeting, and I think that there's a great future for cooperation between ASEAN countries.
Also, I'm from the Asian Channel from Thailand. Have you decided where would you go as your first trip abroad since your release? I've heard that you've been invited to talk on the World Economic Forum on East Asia, and you decided to go to Thailand as your first trip.
I've always said that the first country I would like to visit, the first foreign country that I would like to visit, would be Norway, because of all that they did for us when we were going through very difficult times. You never forget those friends who stood by you during the most difficult times. But this is what I would like to do, but that does not mean that Norway would be the first country I visit. It depends very much on circumstances.
Also, yesterday I followed you going to the area of Kormoor village and see how hard you've been. Yes, yes, and see how hard you've been working. This day, how do you take good care of yourself, your health, and your spirit?
I listen to my doctor. And my doctor is not just a good doctor, he also meditates. So we have much in common, and he keeps me healthy.
What if you win 48 seats in this by election? You offer a cabinet post.
If I were to take up a cabinet post, I would have to vacate my seat in parliament. And I tell people that I'm not working so hard to get into parliament simply to vacate my seat.
Do you believe you can change the inside more than the outside?
No, I think it has to go in tandem. We've been working outside Parliament for more than 23 years, and we're very experienced in that kind of work. And that is very, very necessary. Now what we're doing is we're stretching, we're expanding our activities into Parliament. So I hope that the two will be mutually strengthening.
During the discussion inside, we also raised the possibility of working together. When the Aung San Suu Kyi is inside, ASEAN can certainly work with the entire government and look into policies, into areas that we can cooperate. Certainly we have experiences, we have made mistakes. Myanmar doesn't have to repeat the mistakes in the area of agriculture, in the area of industrialization, agro-business, certainly the environment. And I think the purpose is very common here, and that is the people will have to be the beneficiaries of any growth, any development. We'll have to be inclusive, we'll have to be equitable. That's what ASEAN can work with. And now that the lady may be going inside, and I think you should go inside, I think you will go inside, we will work more closely with the whole spectrum of the government, both the government and the opposition, inside, as part of the corporate entity of Myanmar. It will be much easier for us to work, to exchange, and to coordinate policies that would be beneficial to all our people.
Ma'am, can you say that the people of Myanmar are close to achieving freedom from here?
Close, getting closer, let's put it this way. We're getting closer to achieving freedom from here.
Is this report reversible? Are you sure that the majority of the army are in support of this reform? Are you going to support any call for sending some form of general supply?
I do not know whether the army is behind the reforms. I've said this several times, that we do not know whether the army stands with regard to the reforms. And I've always said that until we know that the army is solidly behind the reform movement, we cannot say the process is irreversible. I've never been in favor of anybody going to trial. I've always agreed with Desmond Tutu that it's not retributive justice that we are after, but restorative justice. I think it would be a little bit premature to say in advance what I'll be discussing with him. If I get to meet him, I'd certainly like to keep a few surprises for him.
Very simple question. How effective have the new sanctions been to bring about the kind of changes we're seeing now?
I think sanctions have been effective to some extent, or perhaps even to a great extent. But I say this for the simple reason that, as you probably all know, the present government is very concerned with the removal of sanctions. And if sanctions had not been effective at all, I do not see why they should worry about them.
How supportive
is your family been in your president and
government authority? Well, we brought up the issue of transparency, the issue of international confidence, and the issue that would lead to even further confidence from the international community. And this will also contribute to the preparation for the chairmanship of 2014. And my proposal was that in November 2010, ASEAN ambassadors, ASEAN diplomats based in Yangon were invited to observe the elections. And maybe the government should think about doing the same thing and maybe going a bit further. That is, inviting observers from the capital, or even include reporters from outside, because international observers and media would be the best way to guarantee to the world that things are going right. And if they want to come here, they want to make sure that they know the facts and they know the information. And the president said, we would consider your proposal, your idea, seriously. I take that as a serious commitment. we don't know when the decision is going to come, but we certainly want to make sure that not only the elections day, but the road to the elections, this is, has been the concern of Lady Aung San Suu Kyi, that the road to the election itself has to be free, has to be fair, has to be transparent, has to be equally open to all parties competing in the campaign, because such would be the necessity to guarantee that the elections, the by-election itself, is free and fair and transparent on that day. We can't wait just for that day. And I think this is known, this is very much agreed, and ASEAN will certainly respond to any request, any initiative by the government, that if there is any way that we could help establish confidence, transparency among the Myanmar people, part of ASEAN, and among ASEAN, who has been a supporter of the evolution of this journey for a long, long time, and then the international community, we will do.
I think I have to cut short this conference because I have another appointment. Could I just take the opportunity to thank Al Jazeera for the good coverage you've given Burma issues?